sir. Are you there?
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. O Lord, open my lips. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The five glorious mysteries of the Rosary. First, the resurrection. The angel spoke to the women. You must not be afraid, he said. I know you were looking for Jesus who was nailed to a cross. He is not here. He is risen just as he said. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who most need of your mercy. Mystery, the Ascension. He led them out of the city as far as Bethany, where he raised his hands and blessed them. As he was blessing them, he departed from them and was taken up into heaven. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Mystery, the coming of the Holy Spirit. They saw what looked like tongues of fire coming out, and each person there was touched by a tongue. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those most need of your mercy. Mystery, the Assumption of Mary into Heaven. Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit exults in God my Savior. He has looked upon his lowly handmaid." Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of your mercy. Glorious mystery, the crowning of Our Lady, Queen of Heaven. Mary's dignity is a sign of God's power. He's pulled down princes from their thrones and exalted the lowly. The hungry he has filled with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those most need of your mercy. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To you do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To you do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, your eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of your womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, we fight to the patronage, Holy Mother of God. Despise not our prayers in our necessities, but deliver us from all dangers, ever glorious and blessed Virgin. Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, hear us. God the Father of heaven, God the Son, Redeemer of the world, God the Holy Spirit, Holy Trinity, one God, Holy Mary, Holy Mother of God, Holy Virgin of Virgins, Mother of Christ, Mother of the Church, Mother of Mercy, Mother of Divine Grace, Mother of Hope, Mother Most Pure, Mother Most Chaste, Mother Inviolate, Mother Undefiled, Mother Most Amiable, Mother Most Admirable, Mother of Good Counsel, Mother of our Creator, Mother of our Savior, Virgin Most Prudent, Virgin Most Venerable, Virgin Most Renowned, Virgin Most Powerful, Virgin Most Merciful, Virgin Most Faithful, Mirror of Justice, Seat of Wisdom, Cause of our Joy, Spiritual Vessel, Vessel of Honor, Singular Vessel of Devotion, Mystical Rose, Tower of David, Tower of Ivory, House of Gold, Ark of the Covenant, Gate of Heaven, Morning Star, Health of the Sick, Refuge of Sinners, Comforter of the Afflicted, Solace of Migrants, Help of Christians, Queen of Angels, Queen of Patriarchs, Queen of Prophets, Queen of Apostles, Queen of Martyrs, Queen of Confessors, Queen of Virgins, Queen of All Saints, Queen conceived without original sin, Queen assumed into heaven, Queen of the Most Holy Rosary, Queen of the Family, Queen of Peace, Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Pray for us, Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life. Grant, we beseech you, that meditation upon these mysteries in the most holy rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise through the same Christ our Lord. May the divine assistance always remain with us. May the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Pray to Our Lady of Knock. Our Lady of Knock, Queen of Ireland, you gave hope to your people in time of distress and comforted them in sorrow. You've inspired countless pilgrims to pray with confidence to your divine Son, remembering his promise, ask and you shall receive, seek and you will find. Help us to remember that we are all pilgrims on the road to heaven. Fill me with love and concern for my brothers and sisters in Christ, especially those who live with me. Comfort me when I am sick, lonely, or depressed. Teach me how to take part ever more reverently in the holy sacrifice of the Mass. Give me a greater love for Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament. Pray for me now and at the hour of my death. Our Lady of Knock, St. John the Evangelist, St. Joseph, may the divine assistance remain always with us. May the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Too long. And the response, just the one reading.
Okay.
Yeah. No. What's your name?
I'm
bless you.
Thanks. Longing for light, we wait in darkness. Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people, light for the world to see. Christ, be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light, shine in your church, gather to
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Good evening, folks. It's good to see you all this evening as we journey on through the second week of Ordinary Time. Mass this evening is offered for Michael and Bridget Nally from Colchinny on their anniversary, and also their great-grandson, Jason. As we begin our Mass, we thank God for his blessings and gifts. We acknowledge our limitations, and we ask God's forgiveness for our faults and failings. You were sent to heal the contrite, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You plead for us at the right hand of the Father, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, pardon our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who governs all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the prayers of your people and bestow your peace in our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. You remember that Melchizedek, king of Salem, a priest of God Most High, went to meet Abraham, who was on his way back after defeating the kings, and blessed him. And also that it was to him that Abraham gave a tenth of all that he had. By the interpretation of his name, he is first king of righteousness, and also king of Salem, that is, king of peace. He has no father, mother, or ancestry, and his life has no beginning or end. He is like the Son of God. He remains a priest forever. This becomes even more clearly evident when there appears a second Melchizedek, who is a priest not by virtue of a law about physical descent, but by the power of an indestructible life. For it was about him that the prophecy was made, "You are a priest of the order of Melchizedek, and forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, your response is, "You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old." The Lord's revelation to my master, "Sit on my right, I will put your foes beneath your feet." You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old. The Lord will send from Zion your scepter of power, rule in the midst of all your foes. A prince from the day of your birth on the holy mountains, from the womb, before the daybreak, I begot you. The Lord has sworn an oath he will not change. You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old.
Alleluia. Hallelujah. the kingdom and cured all kinds of sickness among the people. Alleluia.
And the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus went into a synagogue, and there was a man there who had a withered hand. They were watching him to see if he would cure him on the Sabbath, hoping for something to use against him. He said to the man with the withered hand, "Stand up out in the middle." He said to them, "Is it against the law on the Sabbath to do good or to do evil, to save life or to kill?" But they said nothing. Grieved to find them so obstinate, he looked angrily around at them, and said to the man, "Stretch out your hand." He stretched it out, and his hand was better. The Pharisees went out and began to plot with the Herodians against him, discussing how they might destroy him. The Gospel of the Lord. Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Well, I commend you for coming out to Mass this evening on such a bad evening, potential for frost, deep freeze up tonight. But anyhow, you know, our Christian Sabbath, our Sunday obligation, our Sunday observance of the Eucharist is meant to recharge our spiritual batteries for the coming week, in order to help us to do good to others and avoid evil. Our Sunday observance is meant to be an offering of our lives to God on the altar, to ask God pardon for our sins, to present our needs before the Lord, and to participate in the divine life by receiving Holy Communion. Sunday is also, of course, a day to spend time with families, members of one's family, to participate more, perhaps, in family activities, since one has more time, possibly, and also maybe to participate in community, our neighborhood, our parish activities, if there's any going on. For Jesus, he wanted to demonstrate in public the original intention of God in declaring the Sabbath to be holy. For Jesus, the Sabbath was a day of rest to be used in adoring God, learning and teaching the laws of God, and also doing good for others. Jesus took the liberty on the Sabbath of granting healing to a man with a withered hand, and immediately after a worship service. And by so doing, he infuriated the scribes and Pharisees, who were so legalistic that they said nothing could be done on the Sabbath. The Gospel then describes a miraculous healing done by Jesus on the Sabbath, which was a public violation of the Jewish law, let's face it, a very serious thing. Jesus did it to prove that God's intention for the Sabbath was to do good and save life, rather than doing evil and destroying life. After all, when Jesus came and, you know, not necessarily overturned, but summed up the Ten Commandments in two, love God and love others, that superseded any law of the Sabbath. And, you know, two things come up, I think, about the Sabbath. The Sabbath is the coming together of families in a parish, when all the families in a parish get together. It creates, in a real way, a sense of community. Sometimes today we find so many family members that don't want to attend the Eucharist. Common problem here in Ireland. Younger people who don't want to attend Mass. It frequently comes up in just talking to people day by day. It's not just a local problem confined to the west of Ireland. It seems to extend everywhere. Well, you know, then, what do we say about it? Well, you know, after all, it's God's church. God will call people back in his own time. The day will come when young people will need God, and hopefully then they will be open to hear God's message. What can we do in the meantime? We can encourage them. We can talk to them. We can listen to them. We can never argue with them. You know, you can argue people into doing all kinds of things. Maybe argue people into going to a sports event, or argue people into trying a new hobby, or arguing people to go on a vacation to a certain place. But arguing people going to Mass probably would never work. It gives them a greater excuse not to go when people argue. So we should never be discouraged about this. We keep bearing witness to the Lord in our lives as best we can. Quietly bearing witness to the Lord, doing what we always do. I mean, a few years back, I remember, you know, the U.S. military bishops went to Rome for an audience with Pope Benedict, God rest them. And one of the things that came up was ministry to young soldiers. And bishops were asking the Pope for his opinion. So many, many young Catholic soldiers go to Protestant services because there is no priest available. There's only a priest available in Afghanistan one Sunday a month. So they will take the liberty to go to a Protestant or a Baptist service. And they wants to get to know the participants there, they will continue to go there. He asked them, like, did they have any suggestions as to what could be done about it, as they were running out of options and trying to recruit Catholic priests. And the Holy Father looked at them eyeball to eyeball, and he said, just keep doing what you're doing now. Keep doing the right thing and leave the rest of it to God. Keep doing the right thing, the words of Pope Benedict. And that's what we have to do, I think. And you know, too, the other thing about it is, this is Church Unity Week, a week when we're asked to pray with our separated brethren for church unity. The Eucharist is a great issue in church unity because it divides Catholic and Protestant churches. You won't go into a Protestant church and see the Blessed Sacrament or the Real Presence or a tabernacle because they don't have it. Real Presence, they may not accept. Now, the good news is, of course, I suppose it's above our pay grade, all of us, let's face it. Joining the churches is a 300-year-old issue, but they are working on it, and they're working on it. And I think all we can do this week is, when we say our rosaries, to pray for unity of the churches. There's so many things that we have in common that we can work together with and do work together with Protestant churches on. But I think to be good to pray for unity of all the churches, that the Holy Spirit will guide the churches into a united people of God, which is, after all, the way Christ intended it, I think. Christ came to his apostles, you know, talked about bringing peace. Peace I leave with you, and peace I give to you. And he talked about the house divided, and he talked about the need for unity. So let us remember this week the prayer about Christian unity. And let's also, while we are saying our rosaries, let's not forget people who are confused today, our youth, young people today, to pray for all of our young people who grow up in a world of mass media and conflicting values. And many of them are confused. So I think to guide them, to pray for them, is a wonderful thing to do. And, we can throw our hands in the air and say, well, they don't do this or they don't do that. They are the young church of the present. We say that the church of the future, they are the young church of the present. And I think today that to pray to Our Lady of Knock to guide them and to inspire them and to keep them open to the Spirit of God would be a wonderful thing to do. I suggest that we do that perhaps when we say our rosaries each day, to do a decade of the rosary for the youth of today. you know, now a little bit apprehensive about the future. After all, when you look at the world, high costs, cost of living crisis, wars in Europe, it's very easy for them to get a little bit disenchanted. So we have to encourage them. So I do commend that to you. May Almighty God, through the intercession of Our Lady of Knock, be in your minds and in your hearts and also in your families, that you may grow in faith and peace this year and always. Amen. Son and of the Holy Spirit now. Amen. Please stand now for the prayers of the faithful. And the Lord be with you. Let us pray. Lord, gathered in faith, we bring our prayers and petitions before you. We pray for Pope Francis and our Bishop Francis. May the Lord guide them in shepherding the people entrusted to them. Lord, hear us. For our doctors, nurses, carers, and all in emergency services who work to keep us safe in these times, may the Lord protect them in their work. Lord, hear us. We understand that life is fragile. We pray that all life, which is a gift of God, may be cherished and protected. Lord, hear us. We pray for all who are ill at this time, in hospitals, nursing homes, hospices, or even at home. May the Lord watch over them, grant them his help, and hopefully recover, that they may give thanks to God for their recovery. Lord, hear us. We pray for all who are burdened by worries or anxieties today, people expecting results of MRIs, tests, x-rays, perhaps health issues, family issues, community issues, job-related issues, or a combination of some of these. May they feel the presence of God in their lives and seek help whenever needed. Lord, hear us. We pray for all the faithful departed, all those who requested masses here, those who requested prayers, especially this evening, Michael and Bridget Nally, and their grandson, their great-grandson, Jason, for whom we offer this Mass, that God may give them eternal peace. Lord, hear us. We hear in the news every day, you know, about the UK having endless strikes. And of course, since our nation is closely tied to the UK, you know, economically and otherwise, we pray that there may be a solution to these issues, which in a way will affect this country in some way, and also affect the people of Britain. Everybody seems to be going on strike. So we pray that industrial peace may prevail in our neighboring country. Lord, hear us. And we remember now our own needs for a few moments, especially church unity, that the nation's Christ, that the church that Jesus founded may be united in mind, heart, spirit, and worship. Lord, hear us. Let's remember now our own needs for a few moments. Let's ask Our Lady of Knock now to intercede for us as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. O Lord, we place our needs before you this evening, and we ask that you hear and answer our prayers as always, through Christ our Lord. Pray, brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Francis our Bishop, all the clergy. Remember your servants Michael and Bridget Nally, and their great-grandson Jason, from whom you have called from this world to yourself, and for whom we offer this Mass. Grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We remember all those who have died recently, all those for whom we have been asked to pray, and our own deceased relatives and friends. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. We think of Ukraine and the terrible loss of life. We pray for an end to this war, for peace and for reconciliation among the people between the nation of Ukraine and Russia. Graciously grant peace in our days, O Lord, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. And the peace of the Lord now be with you always. Let's indicate to each other now a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Those watching online, we make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this time receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. In relation to distributing Holy Communion, we ask that you receive only on the hand. If there is someone who wishes a blessing, please indicate by crossing your arms in front of you with a sealed cross for those who need them. If anybody, for whatever reason, has to receive Holy Communion on their tongues, if they come to the altar rails, at the end of the distribution, we will give them Holy Communion. Thank you for your cooperation.
Of salvation.
O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Our Lady of Knock, St. Joseph, St. John the Evangelist, may the divine assistance remain always with us. May the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Thank you all for coming out to Mass this not a very pleasant evening. It's great that you're here. Thanks to our lector, reader, and our Eucharistic minister, and our musician, Una, and also James and the sacristy. These folks play a big part in keeping everything going smoothly here for these Masses, the many Masses that take place in Knock. So please stand now for the final prayer. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love and peace, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Mass is ended now. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, give thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, give